today on Dawn on Fire. Welcome to Dawn on Fire, right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. Today, we're in this stunning house because we're in conversation with this stunning lady, Nadine. Well, you would have seen her performing on stages, at launches. She has been doing so many shows. And then there was a little bit of a pause because she popped a baby. So that was just 5 months ago.
Yes, that was just five months ago.
And you have just good genes, blessings. See, I look like I'm pregnant from the time I was born, just about to deliver. So tell me about how has it been? But you have been busy with your school mostly.
Yeah, right throughout my pregnancy, I worked with my school. And okay. I had a concert, sent them up for exams, all that. So actually, even on the day that my water broke, I worked in the morning.
What?
Yeah.
Okay.
So it was very, he came early, the baby came early, 3 weeks early. So it was a very emergency C-section,
crisis,
yeah, everybody's panicking.
So this after C-section, my God.
I had an option of going for a natural, but I was a bit scared.
Scared about it, yeah.
But now actually, I think I should have, because the recovery period is so much longer when it's a C-section, you know, like months and months, you're still in pain, still all of a sudden you'll get pains, you know, here and there.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
But how has it been shifting from motherhood or... You know, being a girl, but then shifting immediately. Because until the time you deliver the child and get the child in your hand, you don't actually see how it is to be a mum, right?
Yeah. I mean, for me, Danu, to be very honest, I've always been very fond of kids. And I've always worked with kids and stuff. But you're right. I mean, exactly when you are a mother, I mean, it's different. It's a whole new, you know, experience. Because for me, he'll always come first now, no matter what.
It's just a shift. No,
it's just a shift.
It's just like a switch.
Yeah, and you know, you always think while you're pregnant, like, how will I do it? Will I be okay? You know, all that. But once you deliver and once you, you know, go through that whole thing, it just comes naturally. I mean, that's what I feel. And I mean, the first few months are like, it's really hard.
Yes.
It's like sleepless nights and you're in pain.
But
and
now things have got to a routine.
Yeah, now things have got to a routine.
That's the most... interesting part. Yeah. But there's something fascinating about Nadine is the fact that she's a true daddy's girl. And I think what really shocked you, I think 2 years, two and a half?
3 years ago, actually now.
Was, I think, losing your dad. I think
My gosh.
It just took a lot out of you.
It took everything out of me because, like you said, I'm a real daddy's girl. Like, you know, and he did everything for me. Like, you know, from taking me to my performances, he'll sit and wait. And then he'll come and drop me back. He would never let me go in a cab or, you know, get a lift from anybody. And he just devoted his whole life.
And he was a proud dad of your talent.
Yeah, he was a very proud dad. And he was an exceptional husband and exceptional father. And that was a very... I mean, still, it's a struggle for me, like, you know.
Yeah.
Well, you never get over these things, you know.
Never.
People say, oh, you know, it gets easier. But no, you know, it doesn't.
I'm sure you see a lot of him in your... little one as well.
Yeah, actually a lot, you know, everybody says, like, you know, his personality is a lot like my dad, you know, so yeah.
But you know, this whole process of being a performer and now balancing being a mum, because it takes a lot to, because end of the day, your career wise you are a musician, you're a singer, and you want to also establish yourself in that arena. So when it comes to balancing motherhood and this, how is it going to be for you?
Well, I won't lie, Danu, it's really hard. To be very honest, every day I get about 4 hours of sleep. That's about it. Because if I'm not working with my music stuff, I'm with baby. Because I have to give him that time and attention as well. So sometimes I literally don't have time even, like, you know, to go to the washroom when I want to. You know, because it's very tough.
Yeah.
I mean, I work really hard. And thank God I have my mom with me. So she helps out a lot.
Yeah,
with
I'm
baby.
Sure they love grandkids. They're like, give it to me. This is what I've been waiting for.
Yeah, and Dylan is there.
Yeah.
I mean, we all kind of, you know, contribute, but it's extremely hard. You know, there are times where I'm putting to sleep, and I think I've fallen asleep before him, because by around 10, 11,
you're just knackered.
You're just knackered. Like, you're like, oh my God. Like, you actually make conscious effort to keep your eyes open.
Yeah, true.
It's hard. It's really hard.
But she's also into something new, and that's what we're going to highlight, because I think in another few weeks' time, you're getting on stage.
Yes, 30th of September.
There you go.
Just 1.5 weeks.
Yeah, just a few days more before she competes for Mrs. Sri Lanka. And the funniest part is, I think you're the one who has just given birth the shortest.
Yeah, no, of course, yeah. Some of them don't have kids, and some of them have much bigger kids. I'm the only one who has just given birth.
Yeah, so how has that challenge been?
Well, it's been even harder because it's like, so I've got to juggle my music, my baby, and then the pageant stuff. So, yeah.
Did you ever see yourself as somebody taking part in a pageant? Because even in Sri Lanka, this whole pageants are big in this country. But Mrs. title has always been a bit of a sketchy one. They normally nominate.
Yeah.
This time it's a full-blown pageant.
It's a full-blown pageant this time. So, yeah.
And how is it? How do you like being a part of it? Would you ever do another pageant? It's a lot of commitment.
It's a lot of commitment. Yeah. I think that's...
And you can never have an off day.
Yeah. No, I literally don't. Like, that's the whole issue. I mean, if it wasn't, you know, if... for a baby or anything, yeah, then if you have the time, yeah, it's fine.
It's fun, yeah.
Yeah, and one of the main reasons why I'm even taking part in this Danu, because I feel, you know, Sri Lanka has this perception where once you become a mother or once you're married, that's it. I have actually people calling up and asking me, oh, you're still singing? Oh, you're performing?
Oh, no, I lost my voice and I just lost my civilization the minute I got married.
Like, you know, it's like, okay, now you're just like, I don't know, like a maid or something at home. No, I'm serious. That is the mentality that we have here. I mean, to be very honest, I mean, you work so hard.
Yeah.
I think, I mean, it's a lot of hard work, I won't lie. But we do have the ability to kind of juggle all of it.
Course.
Like, you know, if you have good time management and all that.
And women are good at time management.
Yeah.
That's
and
the whole point.
I think, and we need that encouragement here, you know, because, and most girls, they just completely, you know, give up on their body or... You know, they don't... I mean, everything is a conscious effort.
Yeah, and you have to make it.
You have
Look
to,
Look at me, I'm working on my body.
Yeah.
Nobody's calling me for a pageant. All right, let's master the wave, right? If you win the crown, I want me to be the one who has taught you. Before the end of the show, I'm going to teach her how is it to wave like a queen. Right now, next up is, of course, about food, because this show is about food. She is married to a real foodie, I think.
Yes. Yeah. He loves Swiss food.
There you go. It's going to be some real hardcore man's food on the other side. Do stick around. This is Done on Fire right here on Hi TV. I'm so hot, the butt melted from my head.
It's actually on the
Welcome back to the show. This is Done on Fire right here at Hi TV. So right now I'm with Naveen in the kitchen area. Just wanted to ask you, how often do you cook?
I used to cook all the time, but since the baby has come, it has
slowed the pace down.
Yeah, because I just don't have the time.
Now, if you have to give yourself a bit of a scale out of 10, where would you rate your cooking standards?
That I think you need to ask somebody.
The husband?
Probably the husband, yes.
So did you cook for mom and dad at home?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, yeah.
Can't say all of this. I am not here to cross-check with them. So what's your favorite kind of food?
I'd say Thai food would be my favorite.
Really? Okay.
But if I were to go out and eat, Thai food would be my favorite.
Got one thing cleared, you're married to a gym bum, so it has to be meat that he likes at
home. Yeah, definitely, I mean, he would not have a meal without meat in it.
Really?
No chance.
I'm actually quite not such a big meat fan, so which makes it so much more better. Alright, so now that we know about this part, now let's, before we get into what you're going to cook today, I'm going to teach you the first step of a queen's wave.
Yes.
Alright, put your hand out and just turn a little bit.
Just this.
Yeah, that's it. So now I'm going to say, and the winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Naveen. Wave now, wave. There you go. First step. I'm going to do this before the end of the show. We need to be ready, okay?
We're ready.
The
crowd. Yes.
Okay, what are we going to cook today?
So today I'm making like barbecue chicken.
Okay.
And
in a pan.
No. Well. We're going to grill it.
Ah, okay.
So
in an oven.
Yeah, it's going to go in the oven.
Okay.
And some mash.
Okay.
So I've marinated the chicken with soy sauce, tomato sauce, garlic, ginger, pepper, salt, and all works.
And how long would you say it's good to... So is this like something that you go to if you have to cook at home? Is this something that you like? It's like one of your Sunday treats.
Yeah, actually Dylan loves it.
Okay.
His favorite is actually spare ribs. Okay. I was going to make them, but I honestly couldn't find any ribs. I went all around yesterday looking for ribs. Miss snare ribs. I was like, you know what?
Just give it a chicken. Yeah. Right. So how long do you soak, let this marinate for?
At least for about 2-3 hours. I mean, would be a good time to marinate. But sometimes, obviously, if I don't have time, it becomes less.
Okay.
But this has been marinated for about 2 hours.
Let's see what we're going to make. What's the process? Okay. So now we are marinated with ingredients.
Yeah.
Right. Butter the whole dish?
Yeah, just butter the whole dish.
Okay. You use salted or unsalted butter?
Salted.
Right? I just asked. Okay. Actually, fat is not bad for you. Starch is what's bad for you.
Yeah, that's true. Completely agree with you.
Yeah. Starch is what stays in your body and makes it just go berserk.
Exactly, yeah.
So this is good.
Okay.
Now what do we do?
So I'll just dip this in here.
I would have done it for you. I've never touched raw chicken in my life.
So then don't. So and I'll
put
also just put
well?
The, yeah, put the sauce in as well.
Okay.
And
how long is this going to the oven for?
About half an hour.
Okay. And then it's nice and crispy on the outside, chunky and juicy on the inside.
Exactly, yeah.
All right. So about your music school, before we get this into the oven, and before we start dining, there's more for me to eat here. how many students do you have, and what type of training do you do?
I have about 35 students right now. So I teach classical and pop world because I'm a qualified pianist and opera singer as well. And I sent children off for the exams, the Trinity London exams, which are coming up next month.
And you are enrolled with the
Trinity, so it really depends on what the student wants.
Okay.
I mean, if they just want to have fun and, you know, just kind of do theme because they like to, then yeah, we do pop and, you know, like Broadway and things like that. But if it's obviously sitting for exams, then, you know, there's a different criteria altogether.
Yeah,
that's
true.
A different thing. We have annual concert.
Okay.
So my youngest student is 3.5.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, so you have sopranos, tenors, altos, bass, the whole range?
Mainly sopranos. Okay. I mean, there are very few, but I have one boy who sings like amazingly, I think,
But it's amazing how it has so picked up, right? You know, back in the days, it was only a choir those days.
Exactly.
If you have to sing, you have to go to a choir.
Exactly,
but now it has really
Yeah, and also I think it's important for kids, you know, from young days to get on stage, to get over that fear and things like that.
Yeah,
so,
because it sort of grooms them overall. And
exactly, because all of a sudden when you're like 16, 17, you're trying to push them on stage.
Yeah.
It doesn't work like that.
I think I'm so hot, the butt melted from my head.
It's actually on the floor.
Yeah, never mind. It's really hot. I'm dying.
It's
apparently,
really hot.
The day they are shooting, the sun is above our heads, like directly. It's just really bad. We're melting buckets here. Anyway, let's put this nasty peas in the oven. And when we do come back, hopefully your husband is joining us.
Yeah, actually, I just saw him there. So he'll join us in
a
bit.
All right, he's joining us. Let's speak about the truth at home. How good thing is. When we do come back right here on That On Fire, there's high tea. Yes, and you're like, hello. I'm just pulling my 5 kg here on the side. Welcome back to the show, it's Done On Fire. I don't know how I ended up sitting on the head table, but I'm not complaining. It was hard for me to squeeze my way in here. So this is Naveen's husband who has joined us for the last segment. Dylan. But I always say Dylan. There's a problem with those names where you have to, but it's spelled the same way, right?
Yeah.
I get very confused. But those other names where you change the gender is the worst. Like Sureshika. Where is Sureshika? You're like, oh, sorry, man. Sorry, sir. I'm in the call. So this is the man. So this is who we need to cross-question the lies so far. So
thanks,
Anna. No problem. It's just wanted
so
to speak
sweet.
About it. So you are still camera shy? No, it just feels like normal.
A little bit.
So you are a gym buff. It's very embarrassing when you have these people walking around with arms as big as my face. And you're like, hello. I'm just pulling my 5 kg here on the side. So how long have you been this gym?
Probably for the last 8 to 9 years.
Okay.
I started off as an outlet to kind of looking at weight loss and stuff, but then I got addicted to it and I fell in love with it. But
really?
I haven't been as full on with it for the last couple of years.
Really? I am trying to fall in love with it. It's just a relationship that's just not working. So how long ago did you all guys meet?
My gosh. So I knew him since he was like 15, 16.
Oh, okay.
But
from before his weight loss plan.
Before his weight loss plan, yeah. But
y'all
yeah.
Y'all are like a proper if. You're the I and he's definitely the F. But, so okay.
So, but we've been dating for over 9 years now. We've been married for the past 1.5 years.
Like you've known each other for a
long time.
Very long time. So who popped the question first?
To get married?
Yeah.
Him. Because he proposed to me in Singapore.
Alright, I'm going to serve up because this is a part of the show and I have to consume and I never fuss about this part. Alright, okay, I'm going to go ahead. So tell me, Dylan, when you were growing up at home, what was your diet plan like?
I think my diet plan was anything that had meat in it, I was good with.
Yeah.
And you know, I come from a very strict Hindu Tamil background, so we had vegetarian days.
Okay.
So those are the days I would actually go out and actually sneak food into the house.
So this, when you say, so you are you like okay with vegetarian food or you're just...
Oh yeah, I try to eat vegetables and stuff every chance I get, but I'll be okay with all protein diet.
Okay. That's much. But do you believe in this keto diet? Do you think it's even a concept that really works?
I think it's what works for that person. I think each individual body structure is separate. So
in fact, on a keto diet, I can't eat this.
No, not really.
Yeah, that's how sad it is. That's
just be like me, don't die.
Here, we are not blessed with genes like you. I don't know. I look... Seriously, I'm confused whether you actually gave birth to a child or it's just a story that you've made up. Aren't you serving?
Yes, I am. Yeah.
So, in terms of what you see, though, we were talking about a pageantry and all. So, did you make a conscious decision to lose weight for it or because you just got into it like nothing?
No, like I said, like even
throughout
my
pregnancy,
I didn't put on weight.
Yeah.
My body weight was still
the same.
Do you
see that your hips have expanded?
Hips, yeah. I mean, my shoulders, I feel like I've got a little bit broader. But as... That's why I told you, like the last few months I had a very, it was very hard for me.
Yeah.
That's because the doctor said if I actually had a little bit more fat in me, it wouldn't hurt so much.
Right.
Because when the baby was kicking, it was just, he was kicking right to my bone.
Yeah, it's like.
Yeah, just. So.
You're just going to literally be covered by two towers and then.
Yeah,
we'll
I know exactly.
Yeah.
Then we'll do exactly. And I'll be like the little thing
yeah.
in between.
You'll have to tell him, come here. Get out.
But even as for gym, I mean, you can't actually do exercise until
eating. Why are we so proper?
Until you're about 4 or 5 months, you can't. You're not allowed to do any exercise because you can actually, you know,
hurt yourself.
So even now, I did start gym, like very light stuff, but nothing. No running, like, you know.
Your singing career, where is it going to go after this?
I mean, I'll still continue my music school and performing as well.
Mm.
So yeah, I mean, you know, whatever opportunity that...
What do you think about the music industry here?
Well, it's like this, to be very honest, like I think the singular market is a big market.
Mm.
But the kind of music that I do, it's still a very niche market.
Have you ever tried singular?
When I represented Sri Lanka, in like long years ago, I did do a few singular tracks.
Okay.
And
did you like it?
Actually, one of those songs were taken for the Hiripod the Vessel movie.
Oh yeah.
So one of those songs are my songs that I actually composed, and it was there.
Oh really?
Yeah. So sometimes
Hiripod the Vessel is where the four boys and
yeah. So they actually bought the song.
Oh right. Okay.
Yeah.
The song that. Sort of made Anarkali and Roshan and all
the pair.
Y'all should have acted in it.
We didn't know each other. I mean, we knew each other, but we were not dating at that time.
What is your take on where you see music today?
In Sri Lanka or internationally?
Sri Lanka.
I think in Sri Lanka, I think they're catering towards the local market. I think Singhalese market is probably
the biggest
market, so I think they cater towards that palette almost. So I think English music is I wouldn't say non-existent, but it's not as popular. So
not
any
popular.
Artist that is looking to kind of break through in the English industry here, I wouldn't call this the ideal platform.
Definitely.
Mm.
You have to really suffer crawl
yeah.
for. If you make this your bread and butter, you might be just very poor.
Exactly.
Like,
you can't. You're
on the street singing.
Yeah, you can't, because even corporate events, I've noticed now.
Mm.
I mean, I've known certain people have told me who are in the music, they're like, hey, you better stop singing, you're doing your English songs.
Yeah.
and kind of, you know, get to the whole thing in the mark. But right now, I mean, I've got my hands full with
school,
baby, and now with this pageant. So let's see how things go and, you know, what kind of stuff will come up.
So when we master this wave and when you win the crown, you can easily sing a song.
Yeah.
You can let me style it if you want. I'll be
for
the
sure.
one who's running for you from all ages of life. All right, so before we go, we wrap things up. What's next for you in terms of career? Like, are you doing a photo shoot? I normally see like a thing popping up from nowhere.
Actually, I've got a couple of photo shoots coming up that I've actually kind of put a pause on it until the pageant is over because it's just too much of a hectic schedule. And also, another thing that I want to focus on is like, you know, after pregnancy, your fitness. How you can, you know, kind of get back into shape, because I see so many that just let themselves go. Like I said, it's not easy. I mean, you know, you're not just going to lose all that weight just by sitting at home and eating. You know, but if you
just takes its time.
Yeah, and everybody just keeps saying, oh, you know, how do you lose weight, this and that. Even now, even though I don't do a lot at the gym, I still make that conscious effort to go and do whatever I can. And sometimes all you want to do is just sleep, like, you know. So I mean, I'm thinking of in lines of that as well. So let's see how.
All right. So thank you so very much for hosting us. I know it has been a long day for you, and especially she's going through all her mini pageants these days. Are you driving with her tomorrow?
No,
you
he has to go to work.
Yeah, of course.
Unfortunately.
But does he enjoy
weekdays?
All right. Well, thank you so very much. She has many pageants to go through before she gets to the grand finale. Wish you all the very best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being on the show,
thank
and
you.
I wish you all the best
thank
as
you.
Well.
Thank you.
So we'll catch you with another cool episode right here with Danu on Fire right here on Hi TV. Till then, you have yourself a great day, and it's a yummy treat for me on this side. And the winner, ladies and gentlemen, is Nadine. Wave now, wave.
Because she popped a baby.
I'm scared to walk down these stairs. Don't make Gandhi Pamela.